It is quite common to use the ordinary differential equation system to write a model, so today I will teach you some good practices when using ODEs. As a brief reminder, ODEs must be defined in the equation section of the model. The syntax to describe the initial condition is variable name underscore zero, and for the time derivative it is ddt underscore variable name. In addition, doses from the dataset can be applied to ODE variables using the depot macro in the PK block. The first good practice is to define explicitly the initial time and initial conditions in the model. The initial time must be a number, most of the time it will be zero, but it can also be positive or negative, for instance if you have observations at negative times in your dataset. If the start time is not indicated in the model, it will be the time of the first dose or observations from the dataset and may vary from individual to individual. There are a few situations where this can be useful. For instance, if you have a tumor growth model where the initial tumor size is defined via a regressor and the initial time in the dataset is not zero. For the initial condition, it can be defined via a number, here for instance zero. Or it can be a parameter to estimate, here R0 that is passed as an input parameter. It can also be a regressor. In this example, Bayes is here declared as a regressor and will be read from the dataset. Or it can also be an expression using time, for instance, as in this example here. If the value is not defined, it will be zero, but even if you want zero as an initial value, I strongly recommend to explicitly write it. The second good practice is about if-else statements. It is not allowed to write the ddt underscore within an if statement, as I have done here. So the solution is to define an intermediate variable defined for each if case and then a unique ddt underscore that uses the intermediate variable. Be also careful to define the intermediate variable for all conditions. So I may be tempted to write this, for instance, defining the intermediate variable only for times bigger than 30. If you do that, you may have no error but a really unexpected behavior. So the good practice is to really define the variables for all possible conditions. Next, it is also important to ensure that no expression will lead to something that is mathematically undefined or numerically intractable. For instance, if I use a power, I need to make sure that what's under the power, here cc, will never become null or negative. If it is a concentration defined via an ODE, it may become very slightly negative due to numerical integration. So to be safe, the best is to add a saturation as in this example. Here I have defined cc sat, that is the maximum of cc or 1 to the power minus 6. So cc sat will never become smaller than 1 to the power minus 6. And I then use cc sat in the expression here. The same reasoning is also true if to divide by something that may become close to zero. A saturation is also important when the variables can become infinitely large. With a tumor growth model with exponential growth, for instance, the tumor size can quickly become so large that it will be considered by the computer as infinity and lead to a failure of the ODE solver. It may not necessarily happen during the estimation part, but often during the simulation for the VPCs, for instance. So in this case, we can introduce an upper boundary, as I have done here, for instance, using an if statement. Talking about ODE solvers, two solvers are available in monoliths. One for non-stiff problems, which is the one that is used by default, and one for stiff problems. Stiff means that some numerical integration method will be unstable, and there can be many reasons for that. So if during the estimation or the plot generation you get a message saying that the estimation has failed due to not a number in the prediction, or you see that some predictions are missing for some individuals in the plots, then it's wise to try the stiff solver. To use it, you just have to add one line in the model, ODE type equals stiff. And to finish, I would like to mention that each variable you use in the ODEs must first be defined. So for instance, in this piece of code, I use CC here, but CC is defined only here. So this will lead to an error. The solution is to reorganize the equation, either in this way, where CC is defined here, using AC, and CC is then used here, but it is also possible to write it like this. Here, AC is authorized because it has been defined in the initialization here. Documentation on ODEs is also available online. Have a good day!